Hi everybody, it is Andrea Vilnov here, and I am so excited to be coming at you with this week, Let's Make Lunch with Canada Beef. So just a few notes before we get started. Anytime before you cook, if you have long hair, you want to make sure that your hair is up, tied back, put on an apron or something along those lines if you want to make sure that your clothes are protected, and most importantly, make sure that you wash your hands for 20 seconds, warm water, using soap. Really just get in there when you're washing your hands, okay guys? The next thing that I'm going to say is that all of the recipes for the Let's Make Lunch program can be found at canadabeef.ca under their Let's Make Lunch page. So you can see here we have all of the full recipe, as well as the shopping list, which is really helpful to help prepare you for next week's lesson as well. Okay, so lesson number two for Let's Make Lunch is one of my absolute favorites. Today we are going to be making the tikka masala beef skewers. Absolutely love this recipe, so I'm so excited to share it with you guys today. Okay, so just jumping in, what we're going to start off with is actually right here. If you can see it close enough, we have it right here, strip loin steaks. And this lesson is going to be all about fast fry steaks. I'm so excited about that because there's so many advantages to cooking with fast fry steaks. And that is because they are super thin, which means that they cook really quickly. It's easier to get dinner on the table, and usually they're more economically priced as well. So it's a great way to basically cook and get familiar with cooking steak. It's a very good steak for beginners. So if this is your first steak, you are in luck. Okay, so getting going, what we're going to start, I'm going to bring you guys down so that you can see my hands, and I'm going to actually put together the marinade for the beef, okay? Because that's step number one. Okay, so you can see the cutting board right there. Perfect. And what I am going to do, we have our mixing bowl right here. And I am just going to stir in. We have some yogurt. So this is a thick Greek yogurt. And a Greek yogurt is really good in marinades, mostly because it has a little something called lactic acid in it. So lactic acid is in dairy products, and the acid actually helps tenderize meat. So also another sort of food that you can use to tenderize meat is lemon juice as well. It's another acid, right? And this is masala paste or curry paste right here. You can see it. It'll add like a nice color. I know that the recipe just asks for one tablespoon, but if you want to have a little more flavor in your dish, you can definitely add more. Just know that it will be a bit spicier, okay? So I'm just gonna give that a nice stir. And this is going to just nicely coat the beef. Okay, so now I'm gonna bring the beef back over. And you can see how nice and thin it is. This cut that I have here is actually, as I mentioned, a strip loin steak fast fry, but it's a little thicker than I normally get, but that's okay. Like, we're gonna work with exactly what we have. And basically, I'm gonna cut these in half. Remember, keeping your fingers tucked as always for knife safety. So I'm cutting that down, and this can go right into the marinade, okay? So we can do another one right down the middle. Normally, these are a bit thinner, but that is okay. So I'm just tossing them in. We just have one more here. There we go. You can also feel free to trim anything that you see. Just kind of, that's not a big deal at all. You see something that you don't want there, And we're going for about 1 inch thick of strips. That's the goal, okay? So you want it to be pretty thin that way because it's all gonna go onto a skewer. Then I'm just gonna stir this up so that it's all coated. You wanna make sure that the beef is absolutely well coated. And we're not going to, normally with a marinade, basically the longer you let it sit in it, the more flavor it will take up, which is great in so many ways for it to soak up as much flavor as possible. So what you can do is you could do this in advance, and then you basically, you're gonna do it in advance. You can literally just cover it with anything just so that it's an airtight seal and then let it sit in the fridge. And that'll also help tenderize the meat a bit more. Although I would like to say that with this specific cut of meat, it already is pretty tender on its own. However, if you are ended up using a different kind of thin cut steak and you wanted to tenderize it a bit more, definitely leave it. So that would be more so like the round cut steak. That is one that is a little bit more of an economical cut. And in that case, what you want to do is have some other ways to tenderize it, really. Okay. So now that I have all of that kind of just marinating away, I'm just going to quickly go and preheat the oven, and we're just putting it on broil, okay? So you just have to press the broil button. All of the heat will be coming from the top. Okay, so that's set. We're ready to go on that front. I'm going to actually, before I wash my hands, because I don't want to touch anything else because I just touched beef, I just wanted to go over a little bit of some of the different ways that you can actually tenderize meat, okay? So really, there's a couple of different options. If you have a tough cut of meat, there's lots of different ways that you can improve the texture and make it nice and silky and really just like tenderize it at the end of the day. So a couple of these options are, you can use a meat mallet, which I have here. So basically what you would want to do, I'll point you guys back down again. So you would have the steak sitting here. And that will help tenderize it. If that is not something that you have at home, that's completely okay. Another thing that you can do is just use a fork. I'll actually get one of the pieces out here to show you guys. So you can meat mallet it, or, and you just pierce it with a fork. Very simple, and this will just tenderize the meat a bit more. So that is just perfect right there. As mentioned before, another way that I talked about how you can tenderize meat is by putting it in a marinade. And that is actually called, it's basically called a chemical way of tenderizing things, because basically food is science when it comes down to it at the end of the day. And certain things like lemon juice and, as I said, yogurt or dairy and lactic acid, those are acids that are very commonly found in food. So you can use those as marinades to help break down certain proteins, specifically the collagen that's making that piece of meat tougher than it really needs to be at the end of the day. So those are my main tips for tenderizing meat. Another thing that you can do is actually, if you've ever seen shredded beef, what they do to tenderize it in that instance is they're cooking the recipe for a long time, low and slow. So basically it's the combination of there's a liquid present, you're cooking it for a long time, and you're cooking it over a very low heat, and that will break down connective tissue, which will help make your meat all nice and soft and really make it able so that you can shred it into like a really nice consistency. Okay, so just going over here for a second. You know what? That's not going to work. I'm just gonna step here and I'm going to be washing my hands. Also, I wanted to mention that I'm switching out cutting boards. Not only did my hands touch raw meat, but also my cutting board touched raw meat as well. So with that being said, we are going to next be moving on to the portion of this recipe where we will be cutting up things other than meat, and then we're going to switch it out at that time. Actually, before I switch these out, I have one more thing to show you. 1 minute, we're not done. We're not done with the meat, okay? I need to show you guys how to actually skewer these, okay? So what we are going to do, I'm gonna point you guys back down. You can see I have my wooden skewers, my small wooden skewers, and they have been just soaking in some water. Honestly, they're not gonna be in the oven for that long because these pieces of beef are just so thin. So really what I think you guys should do is just make sure they're wet at least. But basically what we wanna do is we wanna make sure that the skewers have been moistened in some way, so that's more important if you're gonna put them on the barbecue and expose them to fire, just so that basically they don't catch fire or burn off completely and then you have no way to hold on to it. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys how to skewer these delicious beef skewers. So I'll point you guys down. There we go. Perfect. Okay. So you'll see, I have my wooden skewers that have been soaked. And we have our beef right here. So I'm going to just kind of go every other way. Kind of be careful because these are sharp. There we go. And as mentioned, the beef I'm working with here is a little bit thicker. So if you have thinner strips, don't worry about it at all, because the original recipe is with kind of thinner cuts. But at the end of the day, we're gonna work with whatever we have, right? That's part of food skills, is knowing that how to improvise. So that is one skewer right there. And I'm going to put it over here. So it is going onto a foil lined baking sheet when it is done. And we're just gonna put it in the oven and we're gonna bake it for around 7 minutes. Definitely 7 minutes for these ones. I originally said 5 to 7 minutes, but these ones are thicker, so they will need the full 7 minutes, that's for sure. So you can kind of see, I'm just going and kind of like making a cute little wavy pattern. It kind of, as proteins cook, they kind of solidify a little more. So you'll get like this really beautiful cut of meat that can go on top of your little pita, or however you plan on eating it. I'm going to put it on top of some naan bread actually today. And tikka masala is an Indian dish, so the flavors we are working with today are they're Indian spices. And I have a little plate to show you just in a second here. Basically, because I wanted to just show you guys a little bit more about what specifically is in tikka masala paste or curry paste, that kind of thing. So I wanted to, that's what I'll go over in a second. Just gonna do probably one more of these so that you guys kind of get the picture. And then I can move on to the next element. There we go. Also, I did want to mention that with these skewers, a great option is that you don't have to necessarily do these in the oven and broil them. You could also do these on the barbecue with your parents' guidance. Another way that you could do it is if you don't want to skewer them like this, you could cook them right on the stovetop. That is definitely something that you could do. Just don't skewer them. And then all you have to do is just put them kind of loose in a frying pan on the stovetop. That's definitely an option that you could do. I'm kind of wondering out there how all of you guys are doing with the lessons so far. I would love to see absolutely any pictures you guys have. You guys working away on, honestly, if you're cooking in the kitchen at all, it doesn't have to be one of the lessons, but please, like, feel free to share it. I know we would love to see it in the comments if you want to share a little image of what you've been working on in the kitchen, any food skills that you want to learn more about. All of that would be so great. I wish that I could have you guys right here so I could kind of see what you guys are doing. Unfortunately, I know I can't see you guys. So yeah, if you guys can please share pictures just so I can see how you guys are doing. Let me know what you'd like to learn more about. All of this stuff would be great. Absolutely. So yeah, please do feel free to share pictures and comments, questions, anything like that. There are people who are addressing the questions, but if it's a question that we're getting frequently, I will definitely address it in the videos. So like, just keep it coming. I want to hear from you guys for sure. Okay, so now going back, this is dirty. My hands are dirty, obviously. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this aside. I'm going to wash my hands. And then we are going to put the masala skewers into the oven. So I'm just over to the side here washing my hands. Warm water, as always, and soap 20 seconds, okay? And really, this is so important because we don't want it to come down to cross-contamination is what it's called in food safety. So you want to make sure that any surface you're cooking with that has had contact with raw meat, any raw meat, that any like fresh veggies that are going to be part of the meal, or anything that basically won't be cooked further, you want to make sure that it doesn't come in contact with that meat. Very important for food safety. And I really want to reinforce that so that you guys are staying happy and healthy, and also that you have just some good habits right out of the gate. Okay, rinsing my hands. I have a towel right here, a hand towel. So you will see now that I'm just going to pop those skewers into the oven. This is what they look like. With a thinner cut, you'll get more skewers than this. Working with what we have here, so I'm just gonna pop them in. And I'm just gonna put the timer on for 7 minutes, okay? Okay, and moving over, since I no longer have that other cutting board that the meat touched, I have a new cutting board. You'll see, remember this from last lesson, that I have a damp towel right underneath, and that just helps prevent anything from sliding, so it's perfect. Always food safety, always knife safety. Remember that, guys. Okay, so what I will be moving on to now is the actual dip. It's called, oh, actually, no. I wanted to go back for a minute and actually talk to you guys about the fact that what actually goes into a curry paste or a masala paste. So you can see I kind of made a spice plate for you guys to kind of show you, because really a hallmark of Indian cooking is using quite a few different spices that are specific to Indian cooking, but using a variety of spices. And using them almost, I would say, completely equally. So basically, the key is that Indian food isn't necessarily always spicy, like oh my gosh, like hot chicken wing spicy. It can be, but also is very flavorful spicy. It has so many good flavors. So if you haven't cooked with Indian spices in the past, this is a good introduction to it, because it's like, it's really easy, but I wanted you to know what kind of is probably in that spice blend, okay? So we're gonna take a look. So you can see my spice blend that I have here. So garlic, very common in Indian cooking, as well as onions. I would say that's probably, it's a base for a lot of different cuisines, definitely a base in Indian cuisine too. We have ground cumin here, great. It's also used in a lot of different cuisines. Bay leaves. So when you're cooking with bay leaves, it kind of adds like a little bit of a bitter, deeper flavor. So you would put about two of these in like a big pot of soup or in a big curry, and then or like a lot of different dishes, basically. And then at the end of it, you would take it out. Okay, so you don't actually eat this one. You just cook with it, and it kind of infuses the flavor into it. And then you take it out at the very end. Okay, so don't eat this one. It would not taste very good. It would be very bitter. Turmeric right here. This is like such a bright yellow color. Be a little careful if you're using turmeric around your white dishes because it will stain your white dishes. Very potent. Love turmeric. This is chili powder, but not in the chili. There's two different kinds of chili powder. There's chili powder you are going to put in a chili, a regular chili, and then there's this chili, which is just ground up chili peppers, and it is hot spicy, like burn your tongue hot spicy. So you only want to use like a little bit at a time, just to make sure that people can taste the rest of the flavors. Like I'm going to say a quarter of a teaspoon, and then you can work your way up, but definitely don't go over a quarter teaspoon on your first time. Okay, guys? And then we have the cinnamon right here. This is like real cinnamon bark. So you can use ground cinnamon as well to get the flavor in there. I love this because something that you can experiment with in different cuisines is actually using cinnamon in a savory dish. That's actually very common. Not as common in traditional North American dishes, but very common all over the world. As mentioned, you can also use ground cinnamon, or you can put these into the dish, just like the bay leaf, and then take them out when it's like infused the flavor in it. Right here we have ground cloves. So that's kind of another sweet flavor too. So basically it's like a lot of different flavors. So it just adds so much flavor. And these little guys are cardamom pods. And how I deal with these actually is the same way that I kind of deal with garlic, and that you just kind of take a bowl and you kind of like crunch them. Because if you look inside, it's like all these little seeds, and that's actually the flavor. And what you want to, or you can also get ground cardamom, but basically what this comes down to is that the cardamom pods are same as bay leaves, same as cinnamon sticks. You mix them in and then you'll want to like pick them out, or if you don't want to pick it out in advance, just warn your family. cardamom pods are very fragrant. It's almost like a perfumey type bite. So if you accidentally bite into one and it's perfumey, that's what you bit into. That's it's a cardamom pod. So yeah, that's kind of some of the major spices that are involved in making masala paste. So basically what you would do, so masala powder would be those ingredients. What makes it a paste is that you're usually mixing in some tomato paste to make it into a very flavorful spicy paste, and usually some oil as well, just because those are really good carriers of flavor. As you can see, Indian cuisine has really mastered the whole idea that you can use a variety of spices, and this will help you, basically how you can use herbs and different spices to add a huge punch of flavor without adding a ton of fat to the dish. So it's great, right? So many different herbs and spices that we just went over there. Okay, so as I said, we are going to move on to the raita. So the whole point of this dish is basically it's a sauce. It's a very delicious yogurt-based sauce that goes on top of the beef. And this is such a nice sauce because if you make something spicy, like hot spicy, the whole point of this dish is to kind of cool off your mouth. The dairy really coats your mouth and makes it so that it just cools everything off so that your tongue is not burning anymore at the end of the day. Okay, so first things first, we are going to put in the grated cucumber. So I have this here, and I'm just gonna quickly grate some cucumber. beautiful. I kind of like to avoid the center because there's just so much water in the center, and we're gonna try and squeeze the water out anyways, just to make sure that the dip isn't too watery. So yes, cucumber adds a lot of flavor. It adds a really fresh flavor, and it also helps with the cooling off your mouth. There we go. Okay, I'm just gonna take a quick second, dry my hands, grab the beef from the oven. And it looks so delicious. So I'm just gonna keep on going with the recipe, and then we'll put the beef skewers on it. So, just do this. This is about a quarter cup here of cucumber. And actually, I'm going to switch this out. I think I'm going to need a slightly bigger bowl by the time this dip is all said and done. So, always go up a size if you're not sure. There we go. Okay, so I have a sink over here, and I'm just going to kind of squeeze it out so that we have... You can see it's a bit drier, right? Just get rid of some of that moisture. As I mentioned, that's about a quarter cup. And then we have some Greek yogurt that I will be putting in here. There we go. Greek yogurt. And it is one cup of Greek yogurt that is needed. There we go. And then once the Greek, so far we have grated cucumber, we have Greek yogurt. We're going to be adding in some chopped onion. It's a quarter cup. And then we have a quarter teaspoon of salt. And we have a quarter teaspoon of pepper. There we go, that's in there. And we also just need to do one clove of garlic, okay? So just while I'm cleaning this up a bit, we're gonna go take this moment to go over a little bit of the chopping technique again, right? Which we are drawing on from the skills that we learned last week. Okay, so I'm just gonna put this down. Here we go, as mentioned, we want to take a bowl and crush, right? There we go. Maybe a little more, actually. Oh, okay, that went flying a little far. We'll get a new one for the sake of this. Okay, so I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna crush it. There we go, so that it is easy to take everything off. There we go. Sorry, it just needs a little more. There we go. Okay, perfect. You can see it's all coming off to the side. Okay, there we go. And same as last week, tip of the knife on the board. And you are just going to drop it through, okay? There we go. And this is our chopping technique. Right here, okay? We want it to be very small. And then kind of just like if it gets stuck, you can push it down. Always push it down away from your fingers. Being careful to keep your fingers far away from the sharp end of the blade. There we go. So I'm gonna put this down, and then this can go into our little dip here. I'll just put those in too. Here we go. And we'll stir it all up. And it actually looks pretty once you get the, see, the cucumber starts to come up. And then it's like, it's a nice white dip with some green coming through. So it's kind of fun that way. Very nice and fresh. And it's Raita, if you guys are wondering. And this is just, once again, basically to cool down the palate. It also adds a lot of flavor. I love using yogurt as the base of my dips. It's also very common in Mediterranean dishes as well. So think like Greek food, that kind of thing, to use yogurt as the base for a dip. There we go. So that's all ready to go. Okay, and so basically what we're coming up to next is that we're just going to be, I have some of the sides here, and we're gonna basically be putting together a plate, okay? We're ready to get going on that front. So I'll point you guys down. Okay, so what we have here is we have some naan. Once again, you can go for whole wheat naan, or you can go for white naan. Try and get as many whole wheats into your diet as possible, but kind of feel that out and see basically what you like that's whole wheat and what you don't like that's whole wheat. And remember to circle back and always try things again, because your taste buds change and you never know, right? So keep trying new things, okay? So we have the naan here on the plate. And then what we can do, I like to put a little bit of the sauce on the bottom just to kind of like stick everything on there almost. And this is the raita that we just made. Raita also keeps well in the fridge for a while. So if you want to make this in advance, as well as marinate the beef in advance, it makes for a super easy meal. We can put a little bit of lettuce on here. I will do some sliced cucumber. See me doing this again? Knife safety again. Okay. So what you want to do is just keep your fingers tucked, thumb behind your hand, right? And just do some cucumber slices. There we go. And when you're building this plate, from a health perspective, right now, if you go and look at Health Canada, they talk about the whole plate, right? And you will see that it's like half of the plate is veggies, and then you have meat as a quarter, you have carbs as a quarter. And then you'll have like a glass of milk or a glass of water or something along those lines. So in that in the plate format, I just wanted to showcase that it doesn't have to be broken up like that. You don't have to have half of the plate veggies in terms of like they're separated from the beef, from the protein, beef, chicken, pork, fish, any of the eggs. All of those delicious protein options, and as well as the carb section, sometimes your dish looks a little more jumbled. So just when you're building your plate, be aware that you're trying to err on the side of more veggies, like more color. And then you want to kind of have beef and have carbs, adding that flavor and adding those nutrients. But really, like, we are trying to incorporate more vegetables onto our plate, right? So, and the more vegetables you try, the more that you'll figure out what you like, what you don't like. And if you don't like them at the time, maybe you just haven't had it in the right way. That's something that I always love to say, because, for example, I'm trying to think. I did not like blue cheese at all. Ugh. Like, really, it was not my thing. But what ended up happening is I tried blue cheese with pear and candied pecans in a salad, and now I like blue cheese in certain contexts. So it's just one of those things where I like to think, don't say you don't like a food, just say, I haven't found a way that I enjoy that food yet. Because it's so important to keep an open mind, especially when you're cooking in the kitchen, right? Okay, so let's keep building our plate. You can see, so we have our carbs. We have a little bit of protein going on from the yogurt in the dip here. And really what we're coming onto now, just keeping on loading the veggies. I have a tomato here. There we go. And I'll just put a little bit of tomato on. I already washed all of these veggies before we came on, so make sure that as you're working with your veggies that you wash them. There we go. If you're having any trouble, so sometimes when tomatoes are too soft and your knife isn't sharp enough, you just don't have, like you just can't get through it and you're really pushing it and you're almost crushing the tomato. That's never a good feeling. So if your tomato is too soft or if your knife isn't sharp enough, you can always use a serrated edge knife like this one. You can use a bigger one. Once again, be careful, same rules, keep all your fingers tucked and just kind of cut down. And also this one's pretty, like this kind of has a flat surface, but as always, if you are worried, just create a flat surface as soon as possible, okay? That's always safety number one. You can see that the serrated edge is kind of nice. Okay, so I will just sprinkle this on top. We have some nice tomatoes. Look at all this nice color that we have going on. I'm gonna put a little bit of red onion, keeping those fingers tucked. And I like to do my onions with small pieces. I don't like it to be a huge bite of onion. That's my personal preference. But you can kind of see from the way that we are building this meal is that it's not a plate with just separate things. It's we're still incorporating all of those healthy elements that we need in a meal to make it a full meal, but it's all going to be kind of piled up so that we can kind of fold it up and enjoy it. That's basically what I'm getting at, is that there's just, you can be healthy and your food can still be really flavorful and tasty at the end of the day. Okay, I'm gonna grab those beef skewers and just put them on a plate. Here we go. It'll just make it easier to show you guys. And it cools down pretty quickly. You can see that I'm kind of just going for it here. There we go. But you can kind of see that it's like nice that all of those flavors kind of like just basically came in there. And we kind of just put that on top there. So there we go. So if they're really thin, I definitely would recommend putting two skewers on top if your beef is cut really thin. This is a little thicker, so I would say that one should do. But there you go. So that is the dish. There we go. Another fun tip that you can definitely do. So another fun tip that you can do is that if you want to get it off the skewer, you can just take a piece of naan and pull it off, okay? And that's just super simple. You kind of wrap it around and get a good grip, and you can just pull it off. There we go. Set that aside, and there you go. So this is super tasty and flavorful. Recommend putting like one more dollop on top. There you go, that's your delicious dish. Tikka masala beef skewers. One of my absolute favorite. I'm so happy that you guys got to join me today. And basically, enjoy your lunch. I hope it went well. Please leave questions, comments, pictures of you guys in the kitchen. I hope that you guys really enjoyed your time today for our next week's lesson. We are actually going to be cooking up. What are we cooking up next week? Havranos Ranchos Omelet. So I'm really excited about that one too. It is going to be basically kind of a two for one once again, because what we're going to be doing is it's kind of like almost like a chili. And then once you make the chili, we're also gonna put it over an omelet. These are really good life skills to have, really good recipes. And yeah, I'm so excited to be with you guys next week. To get those recipes, go to canadabeef.ca, the Let's Make Lunch. And I will see you next week. Bye, guys.